Black Hippie Radio.
This is Bring Your A-Game Sports Talk Radio. And we live down here in the Player K. Plus, we live on Facebook, so y'all can check us out two ways. Plus, you can catch the podcast later on when we're done with this live show on the website. That's BringYourAGameSportsTalkRadio.com. I got the homie Corey C.L. Crockett down here today.
What up?
How you feeling today, man? You bought a big good, bottle man. Of different feel... beer than this motherfucker, man.
First of all, let me tell you what it is. You know, Belgian beer.
Belgian
Framboise. Framboise. You never heard of it? Get in tune with it.
I'm going to try like something out this boot.
But you see this dude. This guy got a big boot as a beer glass. That's the best beer glass I've seen. He winning right now.
This dude.
He
man.
Winning right now. But now, first, before we start, man.
What
up? Pizza the homie.
Oh, Nardo. Yeah.
Rod, man.
Shout out to Nardo.
Hubble Pug.
Rest in peace, man.
You know who he is. Man, you know, say y'all prayers to him and his family, man. We thought he was going to pull through. And he checked out on us last night, man. So, RIP to my big dog, Nardo, man.
Man, my condolences go out to everybody in his family. I know a friend was one of his cousins, Isha. And, you know, I know she probably taking it real rough because when he got hit, you know, she was, man.
That's
know,
like, that's a good one. That's like a brother. You
so,
know? They always together. You know,
it's a lot of fallen soldiers that you know, that done died over there in that area that we grew up in. That's Ferdinand Hubbard, you know, the Cicero area around that way. So, I mean, man, y'all just got to be safe, man, and leave that dumb shit alone, man. You know, good dude.
One team doing nothing.
Good dude.
And the crazy part is...
Wrong place, wrong time, man.
A year ago, 7 days before this, my cousin Corey Baker died in his sleep. New Year's Day, I'll never forget that day.
And you know
all
what?
Of us grew up together,
I don't...
And you know what?
We're gonna talk crazy. About sports, but I don't mean to get off the sports subject, but... It always been in my head like it's a death angel that float through that area for some odd reason, and I don't know why. It's like I don't know, but we're gonna get into sports though, man.
Yeah,
this is Bring Your A Game. This is Bring Your A Game Sports Talk Radio. We talking Chicago sports and more. The Bears, they just picked up a new coach.
Yeah,
I know nothing about him. I'm not gonna lie to you.
I did my little research on him.
I know nothing about him. I just know he come from the janky ass Chiefs.
We're
gonna talk NBA. We're gonna talk NBA basketball. The Chicago Bulls.
Bad.
You got LaVine. He's supposed to make his
Saturday.
Yeah, he's supposed to make his day Saturday. We're gonna talk about that. We're just gonna talk a little bit about everything. We're gonna talk about the Alabama Georgia BCS championship
Great
game.
Game.
I didn't see it.
Oh, Kia, you blinded me.
No, man, no. Big Ten. Oh. It should have been a Big Ten BCS championship. That's what it should have been. Whatever, man. Whatever. It should have been a Big Ten BCS championship. It should have been Wisconsin, Ohio State.
Man.
But anyway.
What up, Thurl?
So, that was my protest, Big Ten. I stayed strong. I stayed true. I ain't watched that shit. But anyway.
Good game, man.
We're going to talk about that. Let him get off about that or whatever. And we just going to sit back. We're going to talk, you know, play some music. Yeah, y'all call in. 708-328-8923. We're just going to talk about everything, man. That's what we're going to do.
Yeah.
This is Bring Your A Game Sports Talk Radio. We live right now on the radio with janky-ass Corey C.L. Crockett. They done brought that janky-ass coach from KC. So you better tell these people some good information about them that they can go off of and live off of. That's all I'm going to say.
You on the spot like that.
That's all. I don't know shit about the man.
I know a little bit.
You better tell us good information because I'm listening.
I know listening. Who better stay, though.
Yeah.
We're going to get into that later, though.
Nah, he ain't staying.
I hope he don't go up north, though.
They should have gave him that job.
I hope he don't go up north. You know what I'm talking about.
We'll be back in Yahweh.
No man separate what we create. Unstoppable, untouchable, motherfucking worldwide bomb figure. Death Row at its finest. MOB, thug for motherfucking life. Motherfucking magnets. Coming at these niggas worldwide. Machiavelli the dumb. My life in exchange for yours. Born hated as a thug. House full of babies. Crying for my lack of getting love. Ain't nobody tell me shit. Till I got a sack of drugs. Double love.
leave, they ain't gone. Call a grave nigga, fucking with a maid nigga, M.O.B. Gunfire getting sprayed quick. Fuck them all, let them understand my plot to get richer. Much more than six figures. I got a plot to get rich and take my attention. A
nigga, I was raised on the streets. I had to hustle just to eat. My role model was killing niggas, so I know I would never be weak. They got me sitting wondering when my life begins. These niggas crossed my father, did my father cross them? Cause I roll with immortal thug niggas, and my number one plan to kill a man and grab a needle and drug niggas. Niggas don't like us because they bitches straight lovers. The president told us to leave because the government don't want us. This Napoleon, I get my pleasure out of sin and seeing blood spilling shit cause I seen it at the beginning.
Falling your vision, gunning them down for every last minute that I spent in prison. We mash together, plus we get cash together. Last whenever, knowing it don't last forever. It's only one way out and one way in. Motherfuckers cross and get crossed out, never made men. We find excuses to loot, cock and shoot, blow the roof off and boof like Rock Ma Rahu. I can't be touched cause of the weapons I clutch, and the niggas that I'm under is just too much. We made niggas.
For now you gon' have to imagine. Call me your prophet cause I'm predicting what's gon' happen. I began the paper, stacking it. Those who be paper snatching will emerge like crack in the 80s. Baby, maybe that's if I slip. But I became official since the start of this. Idi Amin, born July 7th of Fusid Eyes. Precious with all this gave me they hate to cherish. But still I made it, a made nigga made by the game. Made for war, my aim is simple and plain. Yeah, whether it's Kane or these tracks made for your brain, you'll forever know my name.
Down the line, my strap, my head, there will be none of that. A young old Kato playing out more immortal combat with a criminal skill. The kid be me a nigga till he's still and chill. Recognize the real deal, feel a nigga made when I was young and dumb with a gun, but it paid, so I'm busting for fun. And the outcome will be the same every time. We all gon' die, get yours, cause I'ma get mine.
Down wars, we be the Don Juan, so this Russian. Rhymes baptize your mom, while paralyze the public with my mentality of war. Dead bodies and sirens, give it to your roar. To the core, the results of living poor. Got me thinking on a main level. Shooting my gaze to get paid. I'm fucking crazy devil. Mashing from here to there, day by day. Year to year, main niggas on your motherfucking chair. I'm a main.
Call me a bad boy, killer, murder, motherfuckers. Daily know the feds trail me. So my alias Machiavelli, getting lessons from niggas in penitentiaries. Game, when the plot helped me survive several centuries. Lock me in the cage, I display my rage. Surround a court building with the gauge and spray. They wonder if I'll go when they finally. On my knees to God, begging for repentance. I'm from Memphis, said I'm a thug. They got me fiending for my cash like a fiend when he dreams of drugs. This the daughter and I kidnap your daughter. Kill your wife and hit the funeral and tell you just who gave the order. Machiavelli the dawn till I'm gone. I maintain my army of lunatics and stay home till the day I die. I'll be remembered as a paid nigga, outlaw to the grave. A motherfucking made nigga.
Can you feel me? Come close. Get into the mind of a made nigga. Can't be touched. My adversaries get fucked. Feel me? No millionaire dreams. All I want is the cream. I sell my shit to the fiends. All the bitches scream. Come to see to this lady.
We got a bunch of niggas here. They got guns in their car. They got money. They got money. There was a lot of black women.
Hussein Fatal.
What should we do?
Yeah, I mean, Castro. Castro.
I repeat, let them go.
Bring your A-Game Sports Talk Radio. Y'all already know this show ain't nothing but for the made niggas. So everybody that copy, y'all know what the original is. We down here in the Player Cave just chilling, man. Listen to some music. Got the homie Corey CL Crockett. He down here stogie in it. Drinking on some, you know, some different. I'ma try it, man. Save me some. I mean, damn, man, you done damn near knocked it down to the draws.
You know, it's been a long day, man.
I know, but damn, it was just at the gooseneck, and now it's almost
first
down
of all,
to the draws, man.
Do is look at my cup and
I'm just saying, man. I'm just saying, Joe. Blood. Just give me a little bit, man. That's all I ask for, man.
What up, Denise, man?
But we down here talking Chicago sports more right here on this Tuesday.
You know what I'm ready for.
We actually had some nice weather today, and we're gonna have some nice weather tomorrow. Supposed to hit about 50. So, you know, in Chicago, it say 49, but, you know, in Chicago, that's about 55.
We can go play a whole court.
Yeah. Yeah. If it's clear.
Hoop.
If it's clear, most definitely can run one.
You know,
Chicago be thirsty like that. But, you know, y'all enjoy this weather. Y'all be cool. Y'all chill. Y'all stay relaxed, man. And if you got time on your hands, listen to Black Hippie Radio Entertainment. But anyway, the Bears, they done made on to way. They done made their way on to a new way.
That new game.
And they got this guy from Kansas City. Now, from what I didn't know of him, he been with Andy Reid for 10 years.
He's so that a lawyer.
So, like so that mean that he know a little bit about what Andy Reid do over there.
Andy Reid's track record with his assistant coaches being successful head coaches, way better than Bill Belichick. I just thought I'd throw it out there, though, for you Patriots fans. But go ahead, Kia.
So, what you know about this dude? What's the history on him?
Okay. Well, you mentioned that part. You know, he's been on Andy Reid for a
while. Like I say, I really don't know nothing about
him. He worked his way up the numbers, man. The man was like, you know, first of all, he's a quarterback. So, that's why naturally he going to, you know, gravitate for the quarterback. And he been under Andy Reid. We know how Andy Reid is for quarterbacks. I mean, Andy Reid really only coach. As far as the head coach, what? 2 to 3 quarterbacks? Donovan McNabb, Alex Smith. Who else? That's Michael Vick. Andy Reid, as far as like longevity. I mean, he really like, I'm trying to think. I can't think. But just if you look at his history, he's kind of like Andy Reid. He came from under Mike Holmgren, correct? So Mike, I'm coming under Mike Holmgren, and Reid branched off, started doing this thing, and then you got Gruden and like 3 or 4 other coaches that's been successful as head coaches. So if he coming under Andy Reid said, "Man, this is one of my best assistants I ever had." That's speaking highly. I don't know if he's just saying that to get to help the kid get the job.
I mean, part of it might be true.
Right. You,
you know, it might be true, but at the same time, he might be helping him get his job.
But
you know?
If this kid come in the next 3 years, man, we in the Super Bowl. I mean, you know,
damn,
what I mean?
3 years.
I'm just saying.
I want to see a turnaround in a year.
You know, we would love that.
You gotta, but hold on, wait. Let's just say he can do this.
Okay.
Right. What would you say about the Bears organization then? Because you then went on record, a lot of people then went on record of saying shit about the Bears organization. I don't talk about the organization because I ain't in the office. I talk about what's played on the field.
Well, I do.
Well, what would you say?
They found,
because you got a lot of people that say that this ain't a good move.
I put it like this. Like I said last week, they so controlling that a lot of these guys seem like they can't do their job like they want to because they on their necks about every little thing. So now I think, okay, they're giving pace to the hand. Go ahead. You got your guys in here. We're going to sit back. You're going to let you pick the coach. We still going to be in an interview, which I didn't understand that. Usually go to like the last interview. You see what I'm saying? But if they let these guys do their job, kind of like Lovey. Them dudes will run through a world for Lovey. You remember that? Lovey got his guys in here.
Lovey was a people's coach.
Right. You know, Mike McCaskey, he let them, it trickled down. You see what I'm saying? Even with Phil Emery was here. Phil Emery dropped some good guys. It was until later on, you know, that's when it's kind of like the writing was on the wall. Ain't nobody started Urlacking them late in their career. But under his supervision as a CEO, he did a damn good job and it trickled down. That's what I mean by management. It starts at the top.
So this offensive coordinator, was he the offensive coordinator at the beginning of the season?
Funny thing is, I didn't even, just of last week, I had him at the bottom tier because I didn't know much about him. So I was kind of shocked. I had the offensive coordinator from Minnesota.
No, was he the offensive coordinator in the first?
No,
the
it
first
was somebody team. Else.
So he the one the, took over that, that the got eight. Them to that 5-4-0
exactly.
back on that record.
But he was already, he still was under Andy Reid anyway. He was, I think, the quarterback coach, and he promoted him in the middle of the season. And you make a progress like that, that ain't bad. I didn't understand what they did last week.
And this the same offensive coordinator that put together in the second half of the playoffs.
I don't know what the hell that was, man.
Not shit. For the Chiefs to win after they went up big. This is that same offensive coordinator that's coming to the Bears that's going to be our coach, right?
Yeah.
You see why I question shit?
That's why.
Let me say this. You got people out there to say, okay, let's give them a chance. I'm with giving them a chance.
I'm giving him a chance.
But here's my thing is, when I see your track record in big game,